So last week, I promised to discuss this subject that we have postponed for nearly 1 month. It is very important, very interesting, but very difficult. Paticca samuppada, dependent upon origination. Buddha has mentioned this on another occasion. Yo paticca samuppadam janati, so dhammam janati. One who knows paticca samuppada knows the dharma. No need to study anything else. That is more than enough to understand what is life, what is religion, and why we are here, what to do. Everything we can understand through this interpretation. This, when we analyze this one, we can understand the Buddha has started our way of life by taking entirely a different angle without following any other religion existed or existing. After gaining his enlightenment, first week he relaxed, concentrated under the Bodhi tree. Second week he has shown a very good example to all of us. He stood in front of the Bodhi tree for 1 week, paying respect, for giving shelter for him to gain enlightenment. He showed us to show our gratitude not only to living beings, even the plant life. We must be grateful. First lesson he has shown. Third week, he had to perform a minor miracle because many of those non-human beings, devas and angels, could not understand whether he gained enlightenment or not. Just to convince them, he performed the minor miracles for 1 week. And then the fourth week, he started to contemplate on Abhidharma, the deep aspect of the dharma. This is belong to Abhidharma. This analytical interpretation of mind and matter called Abhidharma. This is belong to this Abhidharma, Paticca Samuppada. When he was concentrating on this particular subject, he got the cosmic rays, the five colors, started to spread from the head. Neela, Pita, Lohita, Odata, Manjeta, Prabha. Six altogether. But five colors, last one, mixture of all these. Come out from the head of the Buddha. That is why you can see the one round around Buddha's head. When he was concentrating on this particular subject, Abhidharma. Now, start from the beginning. Avijja paccaya sankhara, sankhara paccaya vinyanam, vinyana paccaya namarupam, namarupa paccaya salayatanam, salayatana paccaya passo, passa paccaya vedana, vedana paccaya tanha, tanha paccaya upadanam, उपादान पच्चया भव भव पच्चया जाति जाति पच्चया जरा मरणं शोक परिदेव दुख दोमनस उपायास दिस इज कॉल्ड पटिच्च समुपाद वन बिग ग्राउंड स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम अविद्या अविद्या मीन्स इग्नोरेंस Ignorance is the main cause for us to suffer in this world and to prolong our existence within this birth and death, and do not know how to get rid of our sufferings, our troubles, our worries, our disturbances. We struggle. The more we struggle, the more we have to face so many problems and troubles and disturbances. That is ignorance. So this circle, birth and death and birth and death and birth and death, start from ignorance. It is like this. When we keep water in a tin outside, say few weeks or 1 month, then you can see sediment there. After few weeks, when you go there, you can see all sort of visible and invisible germs. Later, these germs also sometimes turn into living being like mosquitoes and some others, started in that polluted water. So the ignorance is exactly like that polluted water in our mind, can create so many other things, and germs can create so many sicknesses. So the origin of life is not the ignorance. The Buddha started this existing living being goes round and round and then round and because of ignorance. Therefore, some people think that ignorance is the beginning of our life, like God created Adam and Eve. Not like that. Because universes are infinite. Living beings are infinite. Universes always exist, always decay, always disappear. When one section is decaying and disappearing, new sections developing. This is the nature of this universe. There is no end of world system. There is no utter destruction of world system. There are no utter destructions of living beings in this universe. Living beings always exist in various world systems, universes. The Buddha understood this through his enlightenment. But people could not believe that, because their understanding is not so deep. But today, many people accept and try to gain more experience. The reason is, astronomers, those who have landed on the moon and tried to land in the Mars and various other planets, they strongly believe that there are living beings in many of those world systems. The Buddha mentioned there are many suns, many moons. People could not believe. But astronomers say they have seen in this universe there are many suns and many moons. The more they discover, the more they come closer to the teachings of the Buddha. So, there is nobody in this world who can say the life started from here at the beginning. That is why he says very clearly, anamataggoyam bhikkhave sansaro pubba kotina paññāya. In Anguttara Nikaya, he says, it is impossible to find out the beginning of a life or the beginning of a world. Because everything is changing, changing, decaying, decaying, disappearing and reappearing. Then where is the beginning? Life and the planet, world, universes. But others could not understand. So they say God created. But Buddhism also says, when this world where we live completely disappears, and all those living beings will be appear in various other world systems. Again, the formation take place or disperse particles, molecules, again started to accumulate. Then the formation take place. The whole universe is like this. Appear and disappear, appear and disappear. Then the living beings, when that particular planet disappear, and they will be born in various other planets where there are living beings according to their karma. Because certain places are very unfortunate, certain places are very fortunate, so existence again take place in one of those places according to their own karma. So the Buddha also mentioned, after destruction, when the formations have taken place and some of those devas who are living in various other planets come down for curiosity's sake to see what it is. After that, they had very tempting aroma that they never experienced. Cream on this earth. Finally, they tested very, very sweet, better than durian ice cream, you know. Then what happened to them? They developed their craving. This craving was not active when they were there. After testing this, after creating craving, they have lost their power to go back. Had to settle down here. This is the way how the Buddha has explained the beginning. But it is not the beginning, because existing living beings have come down and settled down here. But other religions, God created first time. But scientists, philosophers, psychologists, thinkers, never accept what they preach, but they come nearer to the Buddha. Bertrand Russell, a well-known British philosopher who has no religion, freethinker, he has written a book. Title is Why I Am Not a Christian. In that book, he says, amongst the founders of all those religions in this world, I respect only one man. Why? All the others made false statements about the origin and the beginning of this life. They have said, this world, these human lives were created by so and so and such time. It shows how poor their understanding capacity about the world to say like this. But Buddha is the only person who never said this world was created by so and so, such and such time, because he knew what this world is. Therefore I respect him. You can understand. Again, they say, God created the earth and human being. After 7 days, He created the sun and the moon. So without sun, how did they count 7 days? They were caught, you know, very badly, you know. Created the sun only after 7 days. Yeah? Then how did they count 7 days? Then H.G. Wells, a well-known historian in England, he says, Bible says God created this world nearly 4,000 years ago. That's all. But when you study geology, we can understand it has taken millions of years for this earth to cool down and settle down. Therefore, how can you believe that? But all of them come nearer to the Buddha. Because the Buddha has revealed the truth. The Buddha is called Loka Vidu. Itipiso Bhagava Arahang Sammasam Buddho Vijayacharan Sampanno Sugato Loka Vidu. Loka Vidu means a knower of the world. He categorized the whole universe into three groups. Satta Loka, Sankhara Loka, Akasa Loka. Satta Loka, world systems where living beings exist, one group. Then Sankhara Loka, element exists without living being. Now moon and so many planets, only element, no living being. Then Akasa Loka, only space, even without element. He divided the whole universe into three groups. Again, he says Loka Vidu. He knew anything that which exists in this universe is subjected to anicca, dukkha, anatta. With the living being or world or the earth or the oceans or anything, subjected to anicca, dukkha, anatta. That means, if anything exists, that things never remain without changing. Cannot exist without changing. Existing means changing. If there are no changes here, there is no visible physical body. Because of these rapid changes, the formations appear. Then, dukkha, friction. Friction, clashes, imbalance, disagreement. Let us take physical body. How many friction, clashes, imbalance? Elements and element. Element and the mind. In the mind itself, friction. Then, anything that exists in our body, blood divided into two groups, red and white, an attack. brain cells start attacking. And whole body is a battlefield. And the world also exactly like this. Now see what is happening. Earthquake, volcanic eruption. I heard yesterday had earthquake in Taiwan also. More than thousands died. Just now I heard. Immediately after Turkey and again another place. Now Taiwan. This is the uncertainty. So, subjected to dukkha, physically and mentally. Physically, pain, ache, uneasiness, because of the imbalance of the element. Now, when you are sick, you go to a Chinese sensei. Then he examines your pulse. Then he says, oh, you have a lot of fung or fung, what do you call? Oh, a lot of fung. Because the pulse beat is not natural. Then he believed that the wind in the body upset. So he gave some medicine. There is no such system as wind. But when some sort of disorder in our nervous systems or muscles or anywhere, then the wind in our body run haywire, cannot control. Then for that they say, boom. Everything that exists is subject to this. Then the mind. Mind suffer more than the physical body. Every minute, either fear, worries, suspicion, anxieties, anger, jealousy, ill will, grudge, enmity. How many things are there in our mind to torture us? That is called dukkha. No one is free. Even after attaining enlightenment or the Buddha, mentally completely free from all these problems, the Buddha. But physically, he had to suffer from many sicknesses because the body is not holy. Physical body is the same. Also subjected to this anicca, dukkha, anatta. When he was 8 years old, he was going to Kusinara to pass away with Ananda, his disciple. On the way, he said, Ananda, I feel very tired. My body is just like a worn out bullock cart. Because no motor car at that time, therefore he said, worn out bullock cart. Cannot move. Then he sat down under a tree. Say, I am very thirsty. Can you go and bring some water? Then Ananda went out to bring some water. Then he showed his physical body. Look at my body now. See the wrinkles. You have seen me about 20 to 30 years ago. Golden color, complexion. But today, look at this wrinkle. If the Buddha's body is also subjected to this impermanency, what about the others? So he is very human, you know. He doesn't want to show this unnecessary, superficial or miracles or all sort of things, but to show very natural way of human life. Anicca, dukkha, then come to the last one, anatta. All the others believe there will be something to remain in our life without changing. Permanent entity. We call soul, self, remain permanently without changing. The Buddha rejected this. He said, there is nothing to remain as permanent entity. Again, scientists support this idea. Albert Einstein, he says, when we analyze this world, elements and energies and cosmic energies, there is no world. The world completely disappears. Scientific analysis. Now we can understand why the Buddha said like this. In the end, there is nothing to remain as a person or as an element or any entity. So, now let us come back to our subject. When we are going on round and round and round, birth and death, and birth and death, and birth and death. In between there are so many things. But our ignorance becomes the main cause for us to suffer in this world. Again, after gaining enlightenment, these words came out from the Buddha's mouth to express his bliss, happiness he had when he felt that he is free from all those worldly bondages. He said, Aneka jati sansaraṁ sandhāvissaṁ anibbisaṁ gahakārakaṁ gavesanto dukkha jati punappuna. It is due to my ignorance. I had to suffer within this birth and death such a long period due to my ignorance. Today, that ignorance is completely uprooted, no more. This ignorance supports our craving. It is very difficult for us to withdraw our craving because ignorance supports. Now I have taken out this craving also from my mind. Natthi dāni punabbhau. No more becoming again, to become a living being, to suffer again. First word came out from the Buddha's mouth after gaining enlightenment. So now we have learned ignorance is the main cause for our existence in this cycle of birth and death. Then ignorance becomes the cause to condition or to create sankhara. Sankhara means good and bad karma, wholesome, unwholesome karma we create because of our ignorance. If there is no ignorance, we cannot create karma. Then you can ask, how can wholesome karma create this? How ignorance create wholesome karma? Without ignorance, we cannot create good karma also. You know that? We do certain good karma thinking to have better life, to go to heaven and enjoy life forever. Ignorance is there. Because of that ignorance, we create this karma. That is why Arahantas and Buddhas never create any karma, completely free. Because they have completed their journey. We are on the way. So, ignorance create wholesome, unwholesome, or good or bad karma. Now, second stage. Then, sankhara paccaya vijnana. Wholesome and unwholesome karma condition our departing consciousness. Now these three belong to previous birth. The ignorance we had in our previous birth, that ignorance created some good karma and bad karma. Good karma and bad karma created this vijnana. That vijnana means chutti chitta. Departed consciousness. Now ended. Last birth is ended. Then that vijnana or consciousness settle down here. Start a new life. So this part start from this first three previous births. Then vijnana, In that vijnana I have told you, there are five energies, ingredients: ignorance, karma, craving, attachment, karma formation. These five things are there in our consciousness. Then, vijnana paccaya nama rupa. That consciousness becomes the cause for mind and matter to join. I think you can remember, I have told you how rebirth takes place. Departed person's consciousness transmitted and entered into a mother's womb. Not only mother's womb, there are four ways: andaja, jalabuja, sansejaja, opapadaka. Birth, four modes of birth: egg, born; womb, born; moisture, born; the dust bin, moisture born. Then opapadaka, a spontaneous birth. A spontaneous means without giving birth, the life come into existence, but not so easy for us to understand. Now, a spirit, ghost, devils, devas, brahmas come into existence like that, a spontaneous. A female never give birth to them. They exist for a long time as they appeared. And then, when that karmic energy is ended, disappear. And then start another life. So, this departed consciousness is there in the mother's womb. Nucleus of life originated already. Then the matter come and join with this mental energy. Nama rupa join. When mind and matter join together, then start to build a body in the mother's womb. Nama rupa, mind and matter. How life originated there. Vijnana paccaya nama rupa. Nama rupa paccaya salayatana. Combinations of mind and matter create six senses in the mother's womb. Six senses: eyes, ear, nose, mouth, then the feeling, mental image, mental object, six. So all these six senses, salayatana, appear because of that. Nama rupa, mind and matter's combination. Nama rupa paccaya salayatana. Salayatana paccaya passo. Because of these six senses, we experience some sort of feeling through our contact. Now, eye, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, mouth consciousness, body, we get some sort of feeling through the five senses. Because of the combinations of the previous two, then experience feeling. Before that, we had no feeling. Passapaccaya vedana. And because of this contact, through one of these five senses, we create craving. Up to that stage, in that newly originated life there's no craving. After developing the senses, when contact external object, then developed craving. A parable is given. A man who had no house to sleep at night, he went out and lie down under a mango tree. He doesn't know that it is a mango tree, but he started by covering his head completely, sleep there. Now he is sleeping. Then he heard something drop. While sleeping, all the five senses are also relaxing. Because of that sound vibration, ear consciousness opened. Now the mind become active through this ear consciousness. Inquisitive mind wanted to know what it is. Then unveil. Yes. Then he saw something. Then the eye consciousness also started to work with the mind. Now he wanted to see what it is. You go and touch. This consciousness also through the body, feeling. After that, he wanted to see whether it is a eatable things or not. A smell. Another channel open. So, now eyes, ear, nose, body. All the four senses are working. After that, he wanted to see, after smelling, whether this is eatable or sweet or not. Because he knew it is a mango. He ate. Very sweet. Craving started from there. Before that, no craving in that mind. After eating, craving developed. Because of this craving, he decided to pluck mango churi-churi. Because this mango tree not belong to him. Now you can understand how craving become the cause for us to create this thing. Ankhara paccaya vijnanam, vijnana paccaya namarupam, namarupaccaya salayatanam, salayatana paccaya passo, passo paccaya vedana. Vedana paccaya tanna. Now we develop our craving. Tanna paccaya upadana. When craving is developed, we want to claim or we want to possess because of this craving. We want this, we want that. Then it's a very big battle. Upadana paccaya bhava. Because of this attachment towards various other objects, bhava, becoming again. Now come to the next one. Started from the previous birth, three. Then from there up to this, within this lifetime. Then, bhavapachya jati. Because of that attachment, craving, becoming again, started. Then, jati. Birth again. One big round. Jati paccaya jara marana. Because of this birth, jara, decay, marana, death. Because of birth, we had to face decay. We had to face death. If there is no birth, no decay, no death. Jara marana, soka, parideva, worries, miserable feeling. Jara marana soka, parideva, lamentation, dukkha, suffering physically and mentally. All these things come into existence, experience because of birth. Now come to the end. Again started craving. You know, the second round. Then one circle we have completed, link from the previous birth, existing here within this birth, and for creating the next existence. While we are here, we are creating our next existence. So one big round. So all the other religious belief that people maintain, rejected by the Buddha, and explain how we exist, why we exist, why we suffer. We cannot blame anybody. Our own craving, our own ignorance become the main cause for all our suffering, physical suffering and mental suffering. By knowing this, the Buddha advised, by remaining within this cycle of birth and death, just like a merry-go-round, going round and round and round. Within few minutes, amount of sufferings and physical and mental feeling, unpleasant feeling, throughout our lifetime, how many times we can gain calmness, satisfaction, bliss, or confidence in our life? It's very, very difficult. Always we talk about our sicknesses, our problems, our physical body, our old age, and family problems, thousands and one problems we are facing because of this birth. But our craving is so deep. So this craving is supported by our ignorance. We don't want to withdraw our craving. As long as we maintain this craving in our mind, we cannot get rid of cycle of birth and death. We can pray to God, we can do any kind of meritorious deeds. If craving is there, no one can stop this rebirth again and again and again. That is why under the Bodhi tree, after gaining enlightenment, the Buddha said, now I have no craving. I have no more rebirth. Enough. I suffered more than enough. I don't want to suffer again within this cycle of birth and death. Then he has shown the path, the methods, how to get rid of this. We do not know. We complain, we cry, we fight, that's all. But we do not know how to get rid of all our problems. The Buddha has pointed out only three methods. सीले पतिष्ठाय नरो सपन्यो चित्तं पञ्ञञ्च भावये. ओनली दीज थ्री थिंग्स. सीले पतिष्ठाय, फर्स्ट वी मस्ट हैव सम सॉर्ट ऑफ डिसिप्लिन. आवर बिहेवियर, आवर कैरेक्टर, आवर वे ऑफ लाइफ. इन एवरी एक्शन देयर मस्ट बी सम सॉर्ट ऑफ डिसिप्लिन. व्हेन वी टॉक ऑल्सो देयर मस्ट बी डिसिप्लिन. व्हेन वी वॉक देयर मस्ट बी डिसिप्लिन. व्हेन वी डू सम वर्क देयर मस्ट बी डिसिप्लिन. So if they are related to moral side, then slowly, slowly we purify. Through this discipline, we purify our mind. That is why people observe precept, 8 precepts, 10 precepts. That is discipline. For us to develop our discipline, to purify the mind. Otherwise, we cannot purify the mind. That is the first. Sile patitthaya. Chittam. Then, train, develop your mind. Mind is very wild by nature. Especially human mind. Human mind is so wicked, so cruel, so dangerous, we cannot find another living being in this universe who is so cruel like human being. Because of that craving develops jealousy. Jealousy create violence, and then whole world become in a chaotic condition because of this mind. In Chakravarti Sihanada Sutra, the Buddha says, human mind can change the whole world system. By developing kindness, compassion, honesty, or patience, tolerance, harmony, understanding. These mental waves harmonize with the nature, natural phenomena. Then everything runs smoothly. Human mind is responsible for that. When this human mind is very wicked, cruel and hatred, anger, jealousy, grudge, selfishness are boiling in the mind. These mental waves pollute the element. When the elements are polluted, friction crashes, earthquake, volcanic eruption, and the climate, all these changes take place through the influence of wicked human mind. Chittena niyati loko. Again he says, the whole world moves because of our mental energy. We do not know how powerful is this mental energy. Thing I have told you, today one man can destroy the whole world within 30 minutes. You know that, isn't it? Where is he? Where is this man? He can destroy the whole world within 30 minutes. Human mind. Who is that? See how powerful this mind. And the same mind we develop, cultivate, can gain enlightenment. Same human mind, we divert the other way to gain enlightenment. This is the nature of human mind. So we are changing the whole world. Human mind. It is so energetic. The Buddha says, Nāhaṁ bhikkhave anyaṁ ekadhammaṁ pi samanupassāmi yathaidaṁ bhikkhave cittaṁ. Mind. He says, I have never seen another dynamic energy other than the human mental energy, which can run so rapidly. Even the lightning, just we have no time to see, appear and disappear. But the mental energy is thousands times faster than lightning can spread. It is so powerful. But we do not know all these things. We blame God, we blame devil. We do not know what is in our mind. Who are responsible for all these things? And therefore, the second item, what the Buddha say, develop your mind, train your mind, cultivate your mind. Then you get paññā, prajñā, supreme wisdom. Wisdom means clear understanding. Now we have no clear understanding. Ignorance, cravings blindfolded us. Therefore we cannot see things properly. When the ignorance is removed, craving is removed, then our mind become very unbiased, neutral. Then we can see the thing not as they appear, but as they are. Vast difference. Because we do not know how to penetrate into many things that we can see. So we take only outward manifestation, or the outlook, or superficial value. But when you analyze, it's entirely different thing there. Then we come to know what we have seen is not the real thing. That we had to gain through wisdom, realistic attitude of the mind to understand things properly. So we never get this from a God or from a Buddha, but Buddha has paved the way how to gain it. That is why we are developing our knowledge, our understanding. We try our best to practice some sort of discipline. Occasionally we make mistake, we violate, yes, again. A small child, when this baby wanted to walk, slowly get up and walk one or two, fall down. And again get up and walk, again fall down. But never give up. In the same manner, when we try to observe principles or seal or precept or moral, we violate, we break. But don't give up. Try again and again. And one day, we will be to overcome all our weaknesses. Then we become perfect. Now we are not perfect. Any moment can influence our mind to do wicked things, bad things, immoral things. The mind is subjected to all these external influence. So if we practice this discipline, mental discipline, verbal discipline, physical discipline, then everything slowly calm down. Then come to the development of the mind after that. Without discipline, we cannot develop. Then, when the mind is developed, when remove all the dark clouds from the mind, we gain brightness in the mind. At the moment, we have only darkness, no brightness in our mind. That is why we create all sort of imagination, misconcept, misunderstanding, because we cannot see things properly. We cannot understand things properly. When the brightness arose in the mind, no one can mislead us. No one can influence us to commit evil or immoral or wicked things. Because we can understand the fact or the reality in our life. That is final stage. After that, perfection. Perfection means near the gate to enter into Nirvana. Waiting until they open the gate of Nirvana to enter into this. We have reached up to the gate of Nirvana. When the physical body is dissolved, enter into Nirvana. With this physical body we cannot enter. Now you can understand how Buddha has shown the path for us to see the end of our physical and mental unsatisfactoriness that we are experiencing every minute in our life. Now, this is called paticca samuppada, dependent upon this. Because of this, this will appear. Because of that, this will appear. Because of this, this will appear. Again, the scientific interpretation. Why they come nearer to the Buddha? Albert Einstein, relativity, theory of relativity, exactly the same thing. He says, one particular item cannot remain alone without depending on another thing. Because of this, another thing comes into existence. Because of that, another thing comes into existence. Scientific interpretation. The same thing what the Buddha has said. But take different shape, different form, different colors. But depending on something. That something people introduce as God. When we cannot understand anything, we say, oh, God created. Finish. Nothing to study. Nothing to think. God created. That's so. But these scientists and the Buddha could not satisfy with that. They wanted to find out what is the cause. So relativity introduced by Albert Einstein is exactly the same thing. And one particular plant or life or element or energy cannot exist alone without depending on something else. And then after that, this existence, this energy, this element, this life condition or produce another one. So that one cannot exist without depending on others. That is why the whole universe exists. This is the teachings of the Buddha. That is why Albert Einstein says, according to our scientific education in time to come, if religion is needed, only Buddhism can stand. They knew what the Buddha told. Everything what they discover, then they come nearer to the Buddha. But they go far away from other religion. All these modern discoveries contradict to many of all those religions. So it is a religion for people to realize by thinking and understanding, but not simply developing faith and belief. Never gain wisdom. Faith and belief cannot give wisdom. But when we understand, then understand we have to think. Without thinking there is no understanding. But many other religions, what they do, they give some belief. Or you must believe. This is given by the God. So they accept this and hold on in the mind. When they hold on this, they believe this is right, all the others are wrong. That is how they become fanatics. Because they never think. No time to think, only just believe. And they were advised not to listen to other religious talk, not to read other religious book, not to visit another place of worship. Why? If they listen to another talk, another religion, if they read another religious book, the thing that they are holding in the mind may drop. You understand? See how clever they are. Oh, you cannot read other religious book, you cannot listen to another religion. But the Buddha says, you must study, you must learn many things from other religions also, good thing. Because one religious teacher cannot explain everything in this universe. Therefore, good teaching you can find in other religions also. But others cannot accept this. They think they are right, others are wrong. I think enough today. Blessings. Sabbitiyo vajjantu sabbrogo vinasatu mate vatantarayo sukhi digayuko bhava bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata sabba buddhanu bhavena sada satti vantute bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata sabba dhamma anubhavena sada satti bhantute bhavatu sabba mangalam rakkantu sabba devata sabba sangha anubhavena sada satti bhantute nakkhattayakka bhutanam papaggaha nivarana parittassanubhavena hantvate sanupaddave nakkhattayakka bhutanam papaggaha nivarana parittassanubhavena hantvate sanupaddave nakkhattayakka bhutanam papaggaha nivarana parittassanubhavena hantvate sanupaddave. So the peace.